Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. My name is Benjamin Cephalo. I'm the Director of Product Management for Cloud here at MongoDB. Today we're going to talk about backup and how it works with Ops Manager, Cloud Manager, and Atlas. Let's get going. First off, please take a second to read this. It basically says, don't make any trades of our stock on what you're about to see in this presentation. Thank you. First off, let's quickly level set. You're not going to hear me talk about disaster recovery today. What we really want to talk about is data recovery, and here's why. MongoDB is a distributed system. Whether you're using Atlas, which we always deploy by default, and no one can change this, a three-node replica set, or Cloud Manager or Ops Manager, the best practice is that three-node replica set. And the reason for that is, if something happens to the primary, the secondaries will pick up after it. And that's great. And properly architected, that can protect you from any crazy disaster that would bring down the entire node. But what's more common in this type of setup is that something happens to the data. And when that happens, of course, it gets replicated to the other nodes. So it's not about the cluster going away or you having a disaster to your data center or your cloud provider. It's more about that everything is still up and running, but your data has gone missing or someone has made a mistake. So that's what we're going to focus on today, is about data recovery. First, let's talk about Ops Manager and the future of that architecture. Today, Ops Manager looks a little like this. We have clusters that we want to back up on the left-hand side. We have some agents. Right now we have three. Backup agent, monitoring agent, automation agent. Then we have the app servers of Ops Manager. Then we need the backup daemons, which house the head DBs, which is what we take the snapshots of. Then we have to store the snapshots somewhere. So that's either like a block store, like an S3 or the MongoDB block store, or it can be also on a file system. And we need the oplog stores to enable point-in-time restore. That's how we get down to that granular point-in-time objective that you have. This is a lot of boxes and a lot of lines. There's a lot of data flowing all over the place. Our goals for the new architecture were reduce the architectural complexities, reduce cost, and to boost performance, both on initially taking your backup and also on restores. So in 4.2, we introduced WireTiger checkpoints. And WireTiger checkpoints is a brand new way of thinking about backup for MongoDB. What we did was we enhanced WireTiger, the storage engine behind MongoDB, to be able to checkpoint itself. We then moved those checkpoints into the long-term snapshot storage. By doing it this way, this eliminates the need to have the head DBs, which also removes the need for initial syncs. Just this alone reduces cost, reduces your architectural complexities, and reduces just your overall storage footprint of the environment. And then, of course, we consolidated agents from having three to just one, which just makes everyone happier in the first place. So we go from an architecture like this to this new architecture. You'll notice there's only one agent on the left-hand side. We've now consolidated Ops Manager app servers and daemons onto the same node. You still need the separate processes because they still do distinct things, but you don't need as much infrastructure anymore. You still need the oplog stores and you still need a place to put your snapshots. Because we've eliminated the head DBs and we are now taking a backup on the cluster nodes themselves, we require that the backup agent exists on every single node. And the reason why is for this. In case a node goes away that we previously were using, we're just going to move on. So it's very important that we can do that seamlessly by having an agent available on every single server. The requirement to use this new architecture is Ops Manager 4.2 backing up server version 4.2. Ops Manager, of course, is backwards compatible with 4.0 and 3.6 architectures as well. The daemons are still needed, as I mentioned earlier. And this is mainly for background tasks and orchestration. as well as to enable Queryable Backup. And as of the May release of Ops Manager, which is 4.2.13, we have full support for point-in-time restores on replica sets and sharded clusters, Queryable Backup, and incremental snapshots. Incremental snapshots is particularly important because in this new architecture, we were moving a lot of data around. Yes, we don't need the head DBs anymore, but every time you took a backup, we still had to move your entire data set from the node we used to the snapshot store. Now that WireTiger Checkpoint supports incremental, that only has to happen once, and then we will incrementally only copy the changes to the snapshot store, making the backup process extremely fast. Future improvements still are included supporting file system snapshot stores. Today in this new architecture, we only support S3 compatible or AWS S3 in the MongoDB block store. We're gonna have the ability to support encrypted snapshots. Then finally, we want to enhance how we store oplog. For those using S3 or S3 compatible store, we'll be able to write the oplog directly to your S3. This will save additional resources and infrastructure needing to maintain oplog stores. So this is what the future architecture could look like by having S3 in the environment and having S3 be your oplog store and your snapshot store, further reducing the architecture required for oplogs and block stores. Great. Now let's dig into Atlas. First of all, let's go through some changes that you've noticed probably since the last time you've seen me talk. Atlas used to have two backup options. And if you're an existing customer of Atlas, you might still see both of these backup options. We had continuous backup. We had cloud provider snapshots. And then we had recently cloud provider snapshots with point-in-time restore. Well, we're renaming those. And so if you are an existing customer with existing clusters, you'll see that continuous backup has been renamed to legacy. And that is now deprecated. If you're on it, that's great. You can stay on it. We have no time frame of when we're going to ask you to move off of it. We've renamed cloud provider snapshots to cloud backup. And cloud provider snapshots with point-in-time restore, we've renamed to continuous cloud backup. And then just remember, continuous cloud backup has the exact same capabilities of what you were using before with the legacy continuous backup, including point-in-time restores and the ability to query backups. And I'll go over that in a little bit. So let's dig into exactly what cloud backup is. We're utilizing the cloud provider's native capabilities of being able to take snapshots. This allows for granular region selection. So before, with continuous backup, we were only able to have certain backup regions. Now, every region that you could be deployed in is also your backup region because those snapshots are stored with your cluster. This definitely helps you solve any data sovereignty requirements that you might have. Pricing is based on disk usage, not data size. And the least expensive region is starting at 8 cents per gig of snapshot size. Snapshots are incremental, except on Azure, but that's coming soon. And this is available on all cloud providers. Let's talk about continuous cloud backup. You get all the same capabilities as cloud backup. The granular region selection satisfies your data sovereignty requirements, and the pricing. But now you have the ability to restore to that point in time that your event occurred. If you've been an existing Atlas customer for a while, you know we've had this capability with legacy continuous backup for a really long time. You'll also remember that we only allowed you to have a 24-hour point in time window with legacy continuous backup. While with continuous cloud backup, we allow you to customize that window. And that customization is endless. It's just a matter of how much storage you wish to pay for. So if you want a 10-day point-in-time window, you can have a 10-day point-in-time window. What continuous backup really does is it allows you to roll back that clock exactly to the point of time that you're either event occurred or someone deleted some data by accident. So it gives you the smallest possible window of losing any possible data. How continuous cloud backup works is we let you select a restore time based in your of your point in time window. So let's say you wanted to restore to 5:05 a.m. today. Let's say your last snapshot was at 4 a.m. The first thing we would do is we would restore your cluster to 4 a.m. And then we would roll ahead all of those ops to the 5:05 timeframe. Now this can happen really fast if you're operating all within the same region. By doing it this way, we reduce the possibility of any data loss. Replica sets can get down to the second granularity if you issue an op time. If you want to use wall clock time, it's 1 minute granularity. Sharded cluster support adds now per minute granularity, which used to be 15 minutes in the legacy system. This is a really big improvement for sharded clusters. But what about the small disasters, right? And the small disaster that I like to think of is that your application's still up and running, but you could be potentially just missing some data. Take an e-commerce app, for example. Maybe I have a shipping database that contains all of the zip codes for the United States. So the application's still up and running, I'm still receiving orders, but for some unknown reason, Colorado zip codes have completely disappeared. Well, you don't want to bring down the entire application just to restore Colorado when all the other states are still available. You'd lose a lot of money from not having your application be available or your store be available for that period of time. So now we just want to pinpoint just that piece of data that is missing. And that's what Queryable Backup is about. It allows you to query a backup that you've already taken, hone in on the exact data that you need to restore. We give you a way to query that, and you could either export the data out or you could write a script to import that data right back into your live production database. And again, all this can happen without taking any downtime of your current application. We used to provide a nice button that said queryable on it on the snapshot view of Atlas if you were a customer when we had legacy continuous backup. Today, what you would have to do is create a new cluster in your project, restore the backup, and then query it like it's just another cluster in your project. We are going to come back with the easy button soon, but it essentially is just going to automate everything that I just explained. But don't worry, I'm going to show you this in a couple minutes. Here's a sample script that can do what I was explaining before. This queries an existing database or that is hosting your backup, and then we'll write back the data it finds in the query to your production database. I'm gonna show you this live right now. So as I mentioned, we have an e-commerce app. It's still up and running, but just people from, let's say, Colorado are having trouble looking up their zip codes. So we have our locations database here in my Atlas cluster. And if I come in through and I look at the collections, I have my zip codes collection. And there's data for the state of Colorado. But for the sake of argument, we are going to delete it. Great, I've now deleted 416 documents. And if I go here, there's nothing there. All right. So the first thing I got to do is I got to restore my backup because I don't want to bring down my demo cluster here in Atlas. I want to just restore the latest backup to another cluster and then query that. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to click on my source cluster. We're going to go to the backup tab and we see we have our snapshot here. So we're going to go ahead and do a restore. And we're going to just select the cluster. It completely clears the cluster, so we ask you to verify. And now the restore has started. Okay, so the backup is done being restored. So now let's flip over to VS Code and use our new plugin that we just released. So I can live browse a cluster. Oh, and there's my locations database. And there's my zips. Oh, look. There are a bunch of my documents. Okay, great. So I know the backup restoration process completed successfully. Now, using the plugin in our new Playgrounds feature, let me split the screen here. So now I can test out my query before I run my script. So right from VS Code, I can use locations and then put my query right in here. And it does do autocomplete, which is awesome. Come to the end of here. Oops. I can go ahead and execute this. And great, I can see that I have results. Perfect. So now I can copy this query right out of here and put it into my script. And now I can run my script directly from VS Code. So right now the script's finding the missing data, querying it, and then writing it back to the live production database. So if I flip over back to here, you can see the data is already starting to be written. We're at 251 and climbing. So this just gives you a super quick example of how you can take a backup, put it onto another cluster, quickly find the information that is missing, and restore it back to your live production cluster without taking any downtime of your overall application. And now this is complete, and if I flip back over here, you'd see that it had finished. Some other features that we support in Cloud Backup today is the ability to bring your own encryption keys. Oplog encryption is available for AWS customers. The other cloud providers are coming soon. Your Oplog is encrypted though. It's just encrypted with our keys versus you, the customer's keys. But as I said, that's gonna be coming soon for the other cloud providers. The backup policy manager is a really big improvement versus what we had previously with the old scheduler. You have the ability to take on-demand snapshots. We support M2 and M5 backups now as well, which is built into the pricing of those two cluster sizes. And now we have the ability to do direct attach restores. What direct attach restores is, if your backup is located in the same region as your destination cluster in the same project, we will just instantly attach that backup to that cluster, making the restores extremely fast. But we're not done yet. There's a lot of other things we're working on. The first thing is, as I mentioned, Oplog today goes to AWS for point-in-time restores, regardless of what cloud provider your cluster is on. We'll be bringing that to all the native cloud providers as well. So all your data would remain in that cloud. We want to give you the ability just to build a new cluster from a backup, seed that cluster from the start instead of going through multiple steps to do a restore. And as I mentioned earlier, we do want to bring you that easy button for Queryable Backup. Thank you very much. Really appreciate your time. Please go to feedback.mongodb.com if you have any feedback you'd like me to know about Atlas and the backup system. And I look forward to talking to you next time. Thanks again.